Hello and welcome to Coaching with AT. Well, friends, thanks for your overwhelming response to our last webinar, where the topic was how to sell to your customers successfully without seeing them face to face. Well, today, to add to our previous topic, I'm going to share something very useful, something very important in this session, and that is 9 mistakes that you should never make when you are selling your customer virtually. And why it is so important in today's situation, because due to COVID-19 challenges, we all are facing to meet our customer physically and face to face. And there is a greater need to reach out to our customer and sell our products remotely. But in doing so, if you are not focused on how to sell your product, if you're not too sure what are the things that you should speak to your customer and what are the things that you need to avoid, there are high chances the customer may not give you the time and attention for which you are looking for. And when that does not happen, I'm sure you will agree that sales also will not reflect. So today, I'm going to share the 9 very important things that you should never do in virtual selling. So let's go one by one straight away. The first and the foremost is sell products and services at all. What does it mean? It simply means that as excited salespeople, we feel that, we believe that we have the best products and services, and we start giving these offerings to our customers. So instead of this, you should first think about that instead of selling products or services, start offering solutions to your product, to your customer. Because when you provide solutions to your customer, you will easily be able to offer the right product and the right service to your customer, what the customer needs. Number 2, start selling without knowing the prospect's needs. So as I said, that if you do not understand what is the problem the customer is facing, how will you offer a product? And many a times in excitement, people start selling their products without understanding the need, because they believe that their product is good and it will be useful for their customer in any case. But we all need to appreciate that every customer undergoes a different buying cycle at different times. So understanding those buying cycles and buying times, he has different problems at different times. Once you understand those problems, then you start offering your product. Number 3, sell benefits out of context. So first problem that I generally see with people is they do not sell through benefits. They generally talk about the features of their product, like this product is very cost effective, or this product has got this feature in terms of its size, in terms of its shape, in terms of its price, but they do not tell the benefit. And on the other hand, there are people who sell benefits, but they are out of context. When I say out of context, it clearly shows that they start telling all the benefits without understanding the customer problem. And again, this will not go inside the ears of the customer that will help him to buy your product. And mind you, you are selling remotely. You have very few seconds and you have very few minutes to convey all those important points about your product by understanding the problem the customer is facing. Number 4, not listening. I think if you are a salesman, and if you only believe speaking and speaking and speaking and not listening, it's gonna cost you a lot, because while you are on a remote selling model, it's so important to build those listening skills. And listening skills has got 2 important parameters. One is called paraphrasing, which means repeating the same things what the customer has said in your own words, and secondly, summarizing. That reflects about listening, because a lot of time the mistakes people do is we call it as hearing, because they are jumping in and thinking about to sell their product and the benefit without listening to their customers. So not listening is a very important thing that you should not do while you are selling virtually. Number 5 is outpace the customer. So when you are over phone, you have a customer who might be slow, who might be a little gentle, but you, if you have a habit of speaking with speed, you are not matching and pacing with the customer. And in other words, it may outpace. Or the other way around, your customer is very soft and slow, and or your customer is very fast, but you are very slow and very, I would say, your pace is not matching the pace of the customer. What will happen? Again, there will be a lack of rapport between two individuals. So if you want to crack rapport with the customer over phone, you need to match the pace. If the customer is speaking with speed or he's fast, you also need to pace up and speed and fast, because when these two kind of energies matches, the rapport starts happening. So a lot of time people do not understand this, and they outpace the prospect. Number six, without preparation. So a lot of time people feel that preparation is only needed when there is a defined object, there is a defined or a pre-appointed call that they are going to do. But I'm sure you will agree that in various situations, when situations are changing so rapidly, you may be given only 5 minutes or 10 minutes, and you might think that what is the need to prepare, because I know my products very well. Well, friends, that's not the case. Even if it is just 5 minutes or 10 minutes of a call, you need to take time very quickly and prepare your call 10 times before you go and speak to the customer. This is one of the biggest mistakes people make, and because either they are overconfident or they feel that they know everything very well, and they make mistakes in this. So never do your call without preparation, even if it is of short notice. Next, that is called oversell. So as I said, that as excited salespeople, we tend to feel that if the customer is giving us time, they are listening to us, we start getting into overselling. And when we oversell, what happens is the customer get overwhelmed, and he generally says, okay, I'll get back to you, or I have some other appointment to attend at this point of time. So don't jump in trying to oversell, because oversell or hard sell doesn't bring you the kind of results that you're getting. Maybe the customer may buy at that time, but then he will never turn back to you as a source of knowledge and value. He will only think that you are a pushy salesperson, and nobody likes the pushy salesperson who tries to oversell or overpush their sales. So avoid that, and that too when you are on a virtual mode. Number eight, not taking no for an answer. Well, as salespeople, we talk with customers with a lot of excitement. We feel that, you know, we can add a lot of value, and that is the reason we go with a lot of excitement, enthusiasm, and motivation when we speak. And the moment we listen that no, we just take it to our heart, and we feel dejected, we feel rejected, and we feel like giving up. And that's what is very, very important, because if you are able to understand that you don't need to take this no personally, you can overcome this no or a rejection fast, and then can prepare for the next call. Many a times people feel that when they listen no, they take it to their heart, and they get demotivated to an extent that they don't go for the next call. So while you're doing virtual selling, and if you are preparing well, you need to learn that this no is not personally. Maybe that particular customer was not ready to buy. So this is the eighth thing. And we come to the last and the most important thing, that is called as mess around with the truth. I think a lot of salespeople feel that they can just win the sale by overcommitting any product or service they are selling. Now, this has got three disadvantages. Number one disadvantage is that maybe the customer may buy your product because you are boosting the benefits that you are going to provide with that product. But later, if he doesn't find the benefits to the ratio of what you have told, he will feel cheated. And once if he feels cheated, he will not give you any referral for the future. And once he will not give you any referral for the future, you lose your credibility. So never, never, never sell and mess around with the truth. Whatever your products has and can deliver, you should be very upfront in telling this, because this creates your credibility, your accountability, and it improves your visibility because you get a lot of reference. Well, friends, the list can go on and on and on, because there are so many things that we need to avoid. But at this point of time, I realize that This is something that you need to learn and understand very quickly when you are planning to sell your customer remotely. Or even though if you get an opportunity to go and meet the customer face to face, you should be very careful about these aspects when you are trying to sell to the customer. So instead of selling your products, you should first of all put a mindset that you are here to sell solutions. And when you are here to sell solutions, you should think about that, what are the problems the customer is facing? So spend a lot of time in understanding the problems, the challenges, the fears, the pains the customer is facing, and then you start selling your product. You will find it becomes easier whether you are doing it over phone or you are doing it over face to face. Well, friends, if you have really found this useful, interesting, then do subscribe my channel, Coaching with AT, and I will be coming back with more learning modules that will help you to learn and apply it in your day-to-day work. Because my sole motto is that how you can build your capabilities and become more stronger in the role that you are in. Thanks for watching me, and let's stay connected.